Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. Peter's friend. All is quiet, cried the bird gaily. Peter had not closed the gate and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Replied, "What kind of a bird are you if you can't swim?" And dived into the pond. Swimming in the pond, and the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's eye. He noticed a cat crawling through the grass. Busy arguing, I'll just grab it. Steadily she crept toward him on her velvet paws. And Peter shouted, "Oh, look out!" And the bird immediately flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat. From the middle of the pond. The cat walked round the tree and thought, "Is it worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, the bird will have flown away." Then Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone into the meadow. "A meadow is a dangerous place," he said. "If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do?" Peter paid no attention to his grandfather's words. Boys like Peter are not afraid of wolves. Grandfather took Peter by the hand, led him home, and locked the gate. Thank you. flash, the cat scampered up the tree. Quacked away, and in her excitement, jumped out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. It was getting nearer, nearer, catching up with her. Then he got her, and with one gulp, swallowed her. Poor old duck inside the wolf. I wonder how she's doing. We'll find out later. This is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch of the tree. The bird on another. Not too close to the cat. Looking at them both with greedy eyes. And he gives that cat quite a scare. Not at all afraid, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. He ran home and got a strong rope, then climbed up the high stone wall that surrounded his yard. One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over this wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter lightly climbed over onto the tree. Then he said to the bird, "Fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Only be careful that he doesn't catch you." Thank you. bird almost touched the wolf's head with his wings, while the wolf snapped angrily at him from this side and that. The wolf wanted to catch him, but the bird was clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter had made a lasso in his rope and carefully letting it down. Caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose.
They went.
Just imagine the triumphant procession. First came Peter himself. The wolf in his hurry had swallowed her alive.